Okay, so I have my Play-Doh model of a cube and some baby powder on the back, which I used when I was putting the Play-Doh in this plastic mold, right, to make my cube. You can see the kind of residue there, the mess. We're going to take some floss and cut the cube perpendicular to the base and parallel to the base, or our first two cuts. And then we're going to cut it a bunch of different ways because the cube, even though it's one of the first three-dimensional shapes you might learn about, and might seem like the most ordinary, really has a lot of beautiful cross-section opportunities when you're cutting it. There's like a lot of cool things you can do. So first of all, let's take our floss and cut parallel to the base. And an easy way to do this is I'm just trying to push through. Just take your floss, wrap it around like a belt. So our cube's got, we're on this nice floss belt, and just pull in both directions. Pull, 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 make your belt cut. Right, and the floss when you pull through, right, make a nice clean cut. And as you might predict, when you cut the cube parallel to the base, right, you get two cross sections that are also squares. Now here's the thing, I'm not going to actually cut it perpendicular to the base as well, because let's think about this. I'll put the cube back together. If I cut parallel to the base like I just did, right, since a cube is the same from every perspective, if I just turn it, right, it's still the same cube. Length, width, and height are all equal, right? Now, that horizontal cut, that one that's parallel, is now a vertical cut that's perpendicular to the base, and there we see our square faces. But like I said, the cube is really exciting, so let me just squeeze this back together. And some of these cuts aren't going to come out perfect, because it's not a perfect cube. That's okay. So one nice thing is that you can cut the cube with the floss to get a triangle. And there's different types of triangles, but what I'll do is I'll turn it this way and show you how that looks with the floss. So I'll turn it this way so you can get a, I think it looks better from this perspective. Okay. So I take my floss and I'm kind of lining up to the midpoints of these edges here, right? And then I cut at an angle toward the camera. So again, this is a harder cut. See if I can even do it with the floss. I'm going to cut down to this midpoint here. Slide it and come down. Again, super rough, but that's okay. So I'm not going to reach the midpoints exactly, right? Because it's a rough cut. But here, when we lift this shape off, right? We can see a very rough version of a triangle. It looks horrible, I think, with the Play-Doh. Right, but you can see it a little bit better here on the shape. Let me just trim this down so you can see what I mean. If I did a better job cutting, slice it there, you can see the triangle itself, right? The shadow's kind of throwing us off here, but there's our triangle, right? This is a triangular surface. It's not flat, it's like indented for me because of the way I cut it, but if you cut it straight, right, on that plane, like the midpoints of those two edges, and then down towards another edge, you'll get a cool triangle. But there are also ways of cutting it to get hexagons and pentagons, and you might think about if you can get an octagon or other shapes, like what are the limits here? And I'm saying you can think about it because I don't want to keep putting this model back together. I think it's already falling apart, and it takes me a while to reassemble it, but oops, there I got it. I'll try one more cut. I really want to show the hexagon, because I think that's one of the coolest ones. Hopefully, I can pull it off with this model. If not, I'll at least explain the general idea so you can think about how to accomplish this yourself. So the goal is to actually cut it so that you're going through all six faces of the cube. Now the faces are these sides here, right, that are bounded by the edges, right? So it's a face, there are six faces, and your job is to cut it so it's touching all six faces. So I'm going to turn the cube just like this, right? Okay, and oops, like that. And I'm going to start at the back here, right? So you can see what I'm doing, I'm cutting along this, right? And I'm just gonna try to cut down towards the camera to cut through all six faces. So already my floss, when I start up here, is touching the top face and the two side faces. That's three faces already that we're cutting through. And then I'm just gonna drag it down, do my best to get that straight line. Really hard to do. I think I should probably use a knife at this point, but this is, right, this is what I'm using. So now I can just kind of pull my floss through. I think I can make that cut. Let's see if I got it. Oh, almost got it. It looks horrific, but here you can see that I got the one side in the bottom, two sides, three sides, four sides on top, five sides, and then the sixth side. This is a really lopsided hexagon. And if you are able to make a super nice cut here, you can get a much nicer hexagon. You want to try to get through the midpoints of the edges around the cube. So that's the intro to the cube. Feel free to explore more cuts. I'll put information in the video for what else you might consider. Thanks.